That in laying or removing booby traps, a mistake by one man may endanger the lives of the entire group engaged in the work. It is therefore desirable that each such group shall consist of the least number of men essential to the proper completion of the task.
The object of this film is to give you the booby trap mentality. That is to say, to make you suspicious of anything which has recently been in the enemy's possession. It will also imbue in you the idea of making life equally unpleasant for the enemy if by any mischance he comes into possession of anything which previously belonged to you. Booby traps can either be set with standard mechanisms or improvised on the spot by using your own ingenuity and whatever materials may be at hand. The effect of setting booby traps in an area is that troops occupying that area will have to examine everything before touching any object or entering any building. This will tend to slow up considerably their rate of advance. Knowledge of what to look for and how to deal with it will, however, breed confidence and avoid undue waste of time. Carelessness, as you see, always brings its own reward. We will first show the setting of booby traps using standard mechanisms. Here a trap is being set in a motorcycle. The pressure switch mechanism is hidden under the saddle and connected by instantaneous fuse to an explosive charge in the toolbox. Once the plunger is inserted in the trap mechanism, anyone sitting on the saddle is in danger of instant death. In all types of booby traps, concealment is essential. All traces of work must be removed. There are certain principles to be followed. First, appeal to the enemy's curiosity. Any attractive souvenirs or abandoned stores are usually sure to claim his attention. This pile of rubbish will illustrate our second principle. Inconvenience the enemy so that he has to move something out of the way. The dump is arranged to obstruct enemy vehicles and will have to be moved, probably by lorries. Consequently, the trap, a number 5 mechanism in this case, is so set that it will not explode under the weight of a man, but only when something heavier comes onto it. The more we can blow up, the better. Ah, here they come, with a truck, just as we thought. That's right, hack in nicely. Over on your other lock. Little more. Now. Here we see a room in a house which is likely to be occupied by enemy officers. A suitable reception is therefore being arranged. This illustrates two more principles. First, you will notice that several traps are being put in to ensure that one at least will prove effective. And secondly, the traps are arranged to catch the enemy through ordinary everyday actions when he is least expecting anything. He may be musically minded. And if there's a piano about, well, it's not difficult to arrange a little surprise to happen when the lid is raised. And when he sits down at the keyboard, he'll find himself playing a harp instead, provided you remember to pull out the safety pin once the trap is set. This pin secures the spring which operates the striker mechanism. It can be removed with thin thread, which can be broken off after the pin is out. Or maybe there's an interesting piece of furniture, and if it has a cupboard, so much the better. Sooner or later, someone will be curious enough to want to see what's inside. And you remember what curiosity did to the cat, don't you? When taking the safety pin out, you must be particularly careful that the trap is correctly adjusted to prevent the mechanism firing at once. If the pin does not come out easily, investigate immediately. And don't forget to hide the loose end of the string. Then there's the hollowed out book, filled with gun cotton and a release switch that detonates immediately the book is picked up. This is a real thriller and it goes with a bang right from the start. Again, see how the safety pin is removed. Never forget the importance of concealment. Always clear out all traces of your handiwork and try to leave everything as you found it. The enemy are not fools. In this case, the NCO wisely sends all his men off directly the job is finished and takes a final look round to satisfy himself that all is as it should be. An important last-minute duty is for whoever is in charge to make sure that all the safety pins have been removed and taken away.
Right, put the top on now. Lay down careful.
Everything is ready.
All right, come on now, let's get out.
Now let us see what happens several days later.
Schlecht, gar nicht schlecht. Gut für mein Büro. Ich werde den Schreibtisch vom anderen Zimmer hereinrücken.
Mein lieber Hans, glaubst du wirklich, dass du dieses Zimmer für dich behalten darfst, wenn Oberst Schulz es einmal gesehen hat?
Warum nicht? Ich muss schließlich irgendwo ein Büro haben.
Ja, aber drunten im Gasthaus, alter Knabe. Oder in einem der kleinen Bauernhäuser. Das hier wird das Bataillonshauptquartier, sobald die alte Herr es sieht. Warte nur, ob ich nicht recht habe.
Trotzdem, ich werde es versuchen.
Selbstverständlich. Du wirst versuchen, wie gewöhnlich. Du wirst zuletzt im Gasthaus landen, wie gewöhnlich. Du wirst immer dieselben Zimmer haben wie der Oberst. Wo du doch ganz gut weißt, wenn ein Klavier vorhanden ist, dann bekommt der Oberst.
Ach was, zum Donner bitte nochmal. Klavierspielerei. Weißt du denn nicht, dass dies ein Krieg ist und nicht eine musikalische Abendunterhaltung?
Genug sein, mein lieber Karl. Hier, trink. Prost.
Another way of using booby traps is to attract the enemy to the spot by a sudden outbreak of fire or an explosion. When he attempts to deal with this, up he goes. These sappers have planted a delayed action fuse to set the hut on fire and are now setting explosive charges under everyday objects lying about outside. If the enemy attempts to put out the fire, he is practically certain to pick up one of these pails of water and thus explode the trap. Well, let's see how it works out.
Guck mal! Hey! 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 Hey!